Big Weather's Big Recipes. Sponsored by First Flight Federal Credit Union.
Hey guys, it's Big Weather with another edition of Big Recipes. And last week we did a budget recipe. Got a lot of feedback, a lot of folks saying they really liked that. They wanted another budget recipe, so I thought I'd come up with a second one. Today I'll give you the final cost at the end, but we are gonna make some chili mac and cheese. Mail's here. First thing we're gonna do is put in a pound of ground, I'm using ground beef. You can use ground turkey if you want to. I got it on sale, you gotta watch for it on sale. I got it $3.99 a pound. And while it's browning, I'm gonna brown up half a chopped onion. If you like onions, do the whole chopped onion. I'm just using half. Of course, my favorite is sweet Vidalia. We'll give that all a stir. Throw the lid on it, let it cook for a little bit. In about 5 minutes, we're gonna chop it up. Give it a stir. Let it keep going. Here we go, we're gonna chop it all up. My wife got me this thing, I love it. Whenever I use ground meat, looks pretty good. We're gonna drain this real quick, be right back. I thought my camera was on, I'll show you what I just put in. I'm using Bush's Chili Magic. I got one can of this, $1.39. It's a good starter for the chili kit, put it all in. Next, I added one can of Rotel. I got the diced tomatoes, green chilies, chunky. You can go fire roasted, mild, hot, whatever you wanna do, this is mild. Next, I got one can of chicken broth, 14 and a half ounces. Those used to be 16 ounces. Finally, one box of elbow macaroni. And that's not enough water. So I added one more can of water using the chicken broth. Cover that up and let it simmer for 10 minutes. We'll check on it in 10. All right, we've let this go for about 10 minutes. Oh, it smells really, really good. Our noodles are nice and cooked. Now we're gonna kick it up a notch. We're gonna add our cheese. I shred my cheese. It's cheaper to buy it and shred it. I use my food processor. If you don't have a food processor, you can always use your hand shredder. Save a little money, and plus, you know, it doesn't have the anti-sticking stuff they put in there with the shredded cheese. This is smoking hot. So we are gonna take this off the heat, let it cool for a few minutes, uncovered. Don't give it a taste. All right, there we go. Check it out. We've got chili mac and cheese. I did a little cornbread on the side. Let's give it a taste. Mmm. Really good. I really like that. If you want to up the heat, you could throw in a little jalapenos. You could use the Rotel that has the hotter spice to it. If you want to add a little cost to it, you put a little sour cream on top. That would be fantastic. And you'll see I did cornbread. I found Marie Callender's cornbread, just add water. It was $2. So with the cornbread, everything on the plate, the total for this is $14.91. Take out the cornbread, you can do it for around $12. $12, it made a pot full that would feed at least 3 or 4 folks. And it's super easy and really good. Chili mac and cheese dinner on a budget. As for me, that food will eat all day long. Yummy. don't.